मैं ये बात जरूर कहना चाहूंगा कि सर, इन माय पर्सनल कैपेसिटी, फ्रॉम माय पर्सनल अर्निंग्स, फ्रॉम माय पर्सनल पॉकेट, आई रन 10 स्कूल सर, वेयर ऑलमोस्ट 25,000 चिल्ड्रन आर बीन प्रोवाइडेड विथ फ्री एजुकेशन. एंड इन ऑल द स्कूल्स आई ऑल्सो रन वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग कोर्सेस. Where this house might be surprised, with all responsibility, I am saying, sir, up till now, in last 20 years, I have trained 2.5 lakh women, sir. And every 6 months, sir, we have a course. We have a course of a spoken English. We have computer course. We have fashion designing course. We have a sewing course, multimedia course, GST course, accounting course, and we have some 22 courses like this. And after completion of the course, what we do is, sir, like a woman has completed a fashion designing course or a sewing course. So from my personal trust, not from MIM, sir, we provide them with a sewing machine. We also have a beauty parlor training centers where we train them for beauty parlors, sir, for ladies. We provide them with a beauty parlor kit also worth some 1500 rupees, where it has a scissors, the brush, the hair dryer and everything. Mehndi designing, sir. Hyderabadis, we have also mehndi designing. So we provide that also. So there are many courses, so I have a good knowledge in this, sir. And at the same time, sir, the MIM party runs 2 hospitals. Sir, in that 2 hospitals, the teaching hospital. Sir, in collaboration with my trust and MIM's trust, in healthcare sector, sir, there is a dialysis technician, CT scan technician, MRI technician, respiratory therapist technician training is there. Then we have operation theater training, X-ray technician is there. Sir, I just want to bring to your kind notice through you to the government is that, sir, already the health university is providing such cases. Sir, in Andhra Pradesh, sir, NTR University was there, then later on it was named as Vyas, now in Andhra Pradesh. Sir, after the formation of Telangana, we have been repeatedly requesting the health university to start such courses. Sir, now what is happening is that, sir, what we need to take into consideration and the important point is that, sir, a student does a graduation for 3 years. Now the question arises, the government of India is saying that graduation studies has to be for 4 years. Now my question is, sir, when we are providing a skill development course, the duration has to be smaller. If it is a 3 years course or a 4 years course, the students are not enrolling themselves. So we have to look into this aspect also. This is a very important. Diploma courses are there, sir. They are too short. The problem arises is what, sir? There are many courses which are not recognized by the government of India. And after, sir, Health University is also offering a course. They started, I went and I met the VC, I requested, gave a letter. Then they said, sir, we'll start BSc lab technician, BSc MRI technician, BSc CT scan. The problem is, sir, 3 years he has to study. So 3 years become a very long period. And after the studying for 3 years, sir, the saddest part is that he has a degree and the degree is not recognized in the international world. Here the problem arises. Sir, we need to make sure that whatever degrees and whatever diplomas that we are going to give to these children, those diplomas and those degrees should be recognized by the International Technical or Technology or Skill Development Boards. This is very important. This has not been done. And Honorable Speaker, sir, for your kind information, Government of India is also running such courses. And they are charging fees for that. 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakhs. So what is happening, sir? A poor student is not able to pay the fees and do the courses. That is why what is happening is, sir, many of the hospitals, many of the colleges are giving an unrecognized skill training which is not recognized. With this skill university, we have to make sure that these courses are recognized. Sir, I also went to the architecture council, which is there just beside technical education council, sir. Sir, there I went and I pursued and I spoke, and they were kind enough. They said, Akbar Sahab, we'll give you some courses. Like, sir, we have landscaping course. Landscaping is there. Sir, it's a very small. But the problem again there is, sir, for this landscaping diploma course, they are asking to study for 2 years. Interior designing is there. So there are many things, sir. So the problem which I am trying to raise through you and bring to the kind notice of the government is that already there are many centers which are offering such courses, sir. Like, sir, I am not against this bill. I am not against it. The reason for me demanding my party to be given to select committee is that, sir, we can have a more thorough discussion on that. Fine, we are having a discussion now, so I take this as an opportunity. Sir, already skill development courses are offered in different departments in the state. Now the question arises is that, what would be the fate of those courses which are being offered by different departments? Are you going to abolish that? Are you going to close that? Are you not going to give a single paisa to them? I'll give you an example. Like Department of College Education, Skill and Knowledge Centers are running, sir, many courses in the also previously in the name of Jawaharlal Nehru Technology Knowledge Center. Sir, crores of rupees are being given and spent. So are you going to stop this? Or are you going to continue this? This is the question, sir. Department of Youth Services. Sir, Department of Youth Services, like Setwin and other ITI, sir, they are also running. Sir, ye jo berozgar naujawan hai, unko rozgar pe lane ke liye, Majlis Ittehad al-Muslimin, my late father had then demanded. Mr. T. Anjaya Saab was the chief minister. Then that time, a Setwin was started. Sir, in Old City. Sir, aaj bhi Setwin chalta hai, sir. To kya aaj Setwin ko aap ban kar denge ya Setwin ko uske andar laayenge?
Mukhyamantri garu.
Senior MLA floor leader of MIM. जो बात पूछ रहे हैं मैं इससे पहले भी कहा आपके नामपल्ली के एमएलए भी घवाते हम लोग ये जो आईटीआई इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट जो पिछले जनरेशन यूथ को सिखाने के लिए इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग के लिए जो बनाए आज के तारीख में सिलेबस आउटडेटेड हो गए वहाँ पर ट्रेनिंग होकर बाहर आए तो बाहर कुछ नौकरी नहीं मिल रहा इसीलिए हमारा सरकार बनते ही हम जिम्मेदारी से सोचकर टाटा इंस्टीट्यूट से टाटा कंपनी से हम लोग जॉइंट वेंचर बना दिए जेवी तो ये आईटीआईओं को हम लोग एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी सेंटर एटीसी स्पेंडिंग ऑफ 2324 क्रोस अराउंड 2400 क्रोस 86% फ्रॉम टाटा 14% फ्रॉम तेलंगाना ये सब सीएसआर फंड से जिम्मेदारी से वो कॉरपोरेट टाटा से हम लोग जॉइंट वेंचर किए अभी जो नामपल्ली में पहले हम कदम उठाए जहाँ पर ज़्यादा बेरोजगार जहाँ पर गरीब लोग रहते जहाँ पर जिसको नौकरी का ज़रूरत है, जिसको ट्रेनिंग देना है। नामपल्ली में चार इंस्टीट्यूशंस के लिए 130 करोड़ से हम इंस्टीट्यूशन एस्टेब्लिशमेंट के लिए मैं खुद फाउंडेशन पे गया। मैं हमारे श्रीधर बाबू जी और आपका MLA नामपल्ली भी उस दिन थे। पूरा दिखाए, मतलब एक्चुअल क्या रोबो मिशन, रोबो वहाँ पर ट्रेनिंग, रोबो में क्या ट्रेनिंग दे रहे, मशीन्स में ऑटोमेटिक मशीनरीज में क्या ट्रेनिंग दे रहे। वो ITS को हम बंद नहीं किए, सेटविन को हम बंद नहीं कर रहे, हम उससे और ज़्यादा अच्छे अच्छे जो नया दुनिया में जो मुकाबला कर रहे वो कॉरपोरेट कंपनीज को हम साथ में लेकर 86% उन लोगों के जेब से पैसे निकाल रहे, 14% हमारे जेब से निकाल के 100% बना के ये सब युवाओं को नौकरी देने के लिए ट्रेनिंग दे रहा है। कोई भी इंस्टीट्यूशन बंद करने का नहीं है, ये अलग इंस्टीट्यूशन, ऐसा इंस्टीट्यूशन है विथ डिग्री सर्टिफिकेट विथ एडवांस्ड टेक्नोलॉजी। वी आर डूइंग ए बेटर जॉब फॉर अवर अनएम्प्लॉयड यूथ। तो इसीलिए मेरे दोस्त से अगर आगे आपको और कुछ डाउट है तो आप शाम को 4 बजे वहां पर आ जाओ भैया। उसके बाद हमारे मंत्री और हमारे ऑफिसर्स भी मैं बोलता हूं कंप्लीट, आपको जो जो ऐसे डाउट्स है पूरा डाउट्स हम लोग क्लियर कर देंगे।